Let us rise. You've been sitting too long for a Lutheran service. Grace, mercy, and especially God's peace to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Dear friends of Christ, the basis for our meditation today, which is entitled Enslaved, is taken from the reading for today from Romans 6. And it's on the back of your bulletin, but it says, "What shall we say then? Are we to continue in sin that grace may abound? By no means. How can we who died to sin still live in it? Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him in order that the body of sin might be brought to nothing, so that we would no longer be enslaved to sin. For one who has died has been set free from sin. Now, if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. For the death he died to sin, once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. Let not sin therefore reign in your mortal body to make you obey its passions." Here ends the text. You may be seated. It's interesting, when we talk about slavery, you know, we know that slavery is not a good thing. But the Bible really didn't have a problem with the concept of slavery. It had a problem with the mistreatment of slaves. It had a problem with the fact that a slave would never have a chance for freedom. And God gave very strict rules in Leviticus for how long a slave could be held, for how long, and then that the person had to be able to buy their freedom, that they might be freed from their slavery. But before we talk about what it is to be enslaved and what is slavery, we should have a definition. And for today's message, the definition of slavery I'm going to use is being owned by anyone or anything. You see, sometimes we're slaves to things that are not really people, but they might be slaves to things. They might be slaves to things in our lives. And we'll talk about that more in a minute. There is one thing consistent about what slaves want. Slaves want freedom. Any slave wants to be freed from it. And so, to be enslaved, to be chained to something, to be stuck with it is to be burdened, to be weighed down. And so I had the question, what can enslave us? What is it in today's world that can enslave us? And oh my goodness, there are so many things. We can become enslaved, and very rarely now, although there is a problem with slavery in our world still today, and the mistreatment of especially young ladies in slavery. What can enslave us or you are things. We can be enslaved by a person, by a people who can put upon us ways and force us to work in ways that we can't get away from. Now, kids, this doesn't mean your parents. Okay, they're trying to train you up. They're not making you their slaves. They're trying to train you. And so that's a whole different thing. You may feel like slaves every now and then when you're told to clean your room or do this or do that or go here or go there, go to bed at a certain time. But you're not a slave. You're a child of the master of the house. Some people become slaves to their emotions. They just live. Some people just get so upset at things. They let their emotions control them. They become frustrated. They get mad. They get happy. They get sad. Some people become slavery to substances. Oh, it can be the terrible things like drugs and heroin and all these other things. It can be alcohol. It can be any substance that entails us. You know, if you can't start the morning without your cup of coffee, you might have a question there.
You know, for me it's Diet Coke, just so you know. But we have these substances, and I always try to figure out, what is it that enslaves me? The answer is, what will I get in my car late at night to go buy if I don't have? That's what has us enslaved. We can be enslaved to attitudes. An attitude such as, you know, well, I always joke that I'm half Irish and half German, so I don't know whether to fight or drink, and I don't know which side it comes from. But you can say, well, that's just the way I am. Well, then you're just letting your attitude or letting your circumstance enslave you. You have to be set free from that. We can be enslaved to dollars, to money. We can constantly be chasing after the dollar and be enslaved to our debts, be enslaved to our earning potentials. We can be enslaved to the stuff that we have in our lives. I don't think I'll ever forget one night back in Michigan, I would videotape the football games, and my son was a football player, and so we wound up standing up about 40 feet in the air on top of the press box with a camera. Stupidest job you ever want to have in your life. Because it's freezing cold, it's snowing and it's windy, and you're standing up on top of this exposed area. And but there, the only dumber job was a guy who stood beside me, the statistician who marked things. I said, you know, you could be downstairs and mark stuff. He goes, no, they want me up here. But I'll never forget, after the game was over and it was cold and the snow was starting to fly, and he said, I got to start putting the toys away. He said, I got to put the boat away. I've got to put all the you know, four-wheeler, all the summer gear I've got to put away. I got to store for winter. And he said, you know, everything I have, I wanted at one time. Now it just becomes a problem. He'd become enslaved to the stuff in his life. We have to think, are there things in our lives which are enslaving us, which really are things which we could get away from, we could do without? But when we talk about slavery in Scripture, when we talk about slavery in our daily lives, if things take a precedent in our life over what is truly matters, slavery is serving anything other than God. And as Paul is telling us in Romans, that's being enslaved to sin. Because when we serve anything more than we serve God, it becomes our God. And God tells us, you'll have no other gods beside Him. That's the first commandment. And He warns us, He's a jealous God. He doesn't, not jealous such as worrisome, but He's jealous in the fact that He wants you for Himself, because He knows that He has your best interest at heart. If you serve anyone else, He knows that they're interested only in enslaving you, not in freeing you. And so we were all slaves to sin. We were enslaved to sin until Jesus came and set us free. And He came to free us in a manner which was totally unexpected. You see, He died on the cross to pay the price for our sins. He didn't come and ask us to serve Him. He came and was a servant of all. He didn't come and demand that we follow after Him. He freed us. And so now we get the choice of what we're going to allow to be our master in our lives. What are we going to follow after? Who are we going to serve? Are we going to serve the things of this world which will enslave us? Are we going to serve the things of God? This past week I've been amazed at the line down by the...
Kavanaugh's.
I don't even go in there except to buy communion wine. I don't even know the name. But my goodness, and so nobody won, so again, we don't get that check for 10% from the lottery winnings this week, but we're waiting. But they are so concerned about winning this money, they're willing to stand outside and buy from a totally random place simply because they think there might be some luck there. If you're willing to stand outside in line in the cold or the rain or whatever to buy a ticket, you might be enslaved. It's almost like a Jeff Foxworthy thing. You might be a redneck. But the question is if Jesus came to free us, the next question would be, why did Jesus free us? What was it that He came for? Why did He come? And why is it important to Him that we are free?
You see, Jesus freed us because he wants us to be free and not become enslaved again. He's now giving us this freedom, this choice. We've died to sin. Our baptisms have united us with his death. And if they've united us with his death, as we read in Romans, they've united us with his resurrection so that we can live for him. Now, we started this service off with a confession and absolution, admitting that, guess what? We haven't got it all right. We haven't made it through a day, let alone a week, without falling short of God's glory. And yet God says, don't get concerned about that sin. Don't let it drag you down. Give it back to me. Give it to me and seek the things which are from above. Seek the things which are pleasing. He wants us not to become enslaved, but he wants us to live as children of God. You see, it reads elsewhere in the scripture, children are not like slaves. A child lives in the house because he owns the house, because he's a member of the family. We are the children of God. We are not slaves to sin. We are children of God, and we live in his house, and we live in his world in a life of grace, sharing out and sharing his love and mercy. And so the question becomes then, so how do we stay free? In this time of New Year's resolutions, which are so common, how are we going to stay free? And the hint is, Jesus has given us freedom. He has died for our salvation that we might have eternal life. He has died that we might live for him. He has died to pay the price for our sinfulness. And he asks us to live, to seek that which is free. His free love, his free joy, and to serve him by serving others. As we go forth this day, let us remember that we might have been slaves to sin. There may be something in your life you've gotten away from. Or you might have something in your life right now that is holding you back. The power to free yourself from any things that's enslaving you is in the power of Christ alone. The power to free yourself from anything that has you enslaved is because you need to recognize the person you are in Christ and the strength you have from him. It's not made by your own merit, by your own strength, but only by the strength of God. And so as we go forth this day, let us live in that freedom. Let us rejoice that we are no longer bound to sin, but we are bound for glory in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us rise.